Among other things we have in common, we have Mr. Kaufman in common. This is, as we all know, this is his the year of his 100th birthday. So talk to me about his values and his life story and how that was and is still a part of the program, and maybe how it's influenced you personally.
The values as they were taught to me, you know, treat others as you'd want to be treated, reward those who produce, and reinvest in society, give back to society. And so I think in some ways, the values don't impact you as much as I think the values find you. So I think that the people who are attracted to the Kaufman Fellows Program tend to be made up of that kind of a thing. But the way it impacts you, and we've also had this conversation with Mickey Slaughter, because we've evolved a couple of them. Like the first one, we've evolved from the golden rule to the platinum rule, which is treat others as they want to be treated. But Mr. Kaufman came up with this in the, it was pre-empathy era, right? So it's understandable. And Mickey said, yeah, that's what Mr. K is always looking for, the better idea. So he would like that. So we're like, okay, cool. I think, you know, reward those who produce. I grew up as an athlete. That made a ton of sense to me. The giving back to society, we kind of rejiggered to reinvesting in society from the logic of giving back implies you took something. And I don't think innovators take things. I think they create and they build assets and they build skills. And I think we have a very, very grateful group of people, as gratitude is our fundamental filter for the people we select. And so it's very natural for people to look, how can I mobilize these different forms of capital and wealth I've created to solve interesting problems, important problems in societies.